shining dots in the sky, power that could not be measured. At that moment, everything clicked. We were born to travel. We have explored the farthest regions. We have mapped the forest and the deepest parts of the jungles. We have explored nearly every end of our planet because we were born to explore. So does it seem so preposterous to seek out new frontiers as our ancestors once did? In the night sky, we see new wondrous lands that no longer exist in our dreams, but in the horizon ahead. What we bring to Mars is what we bring of humanity. This is a quote from JFK during the space race. We chose to go to the moon in this decade because that challenge is one that we're willing to accept and one that we intend to meet. Global warming, overpopulation, diminishing natural resources, diseases, all those issues are unfortunately catching up with us, and we need to change now more than ever. One of the solutions? Martian colonization. Many great scientists, CEOs, and engineers of our time, such as Elon Musk, Lockheed Martin, or Stephen Hawking, have come up with plans to move humans to red planets, plan for colonizations. By establishing a base on Mars, ideally, the first generations of humans will start living there, and as the base expands and becomes more secure, more people will be sent there. The eventual colonizations of Mars will lead us into the next scientific revolution, and it will allow us to explore further than we've ever been. By putting humans on more than one planet, it will better ensure survival as a species for thousands, if not millions of years from now. Others suggest that setting up a moon base first will help us address some of the problems that might get in the way. We face many challenges both ways. The trip to Mars is 250 days. During those 250 days, astronauts will be exposed to cosmic and solar radiations, zero gravity environments, and other many health problems. Due to research, scientists know how to address most of them with more or less difficulty. Now, what about the rocket itself? An interplanetary mission to Mars will likely require a big and powerful rocket. There are some pretty serious gaps in our abilities, such that we don't yet have a vehicle be capable of landing people on the Martian surface. We're not really sure how to store rocket fuel yet, and we're also sure how to keep them alive once there. But it's not impossible. If we decide to put the time and effort necessary into this project, it will happen. Rockets are tricky. No rocket in existence today can take off from the Earth's surface and escape its gravitational pull while carrying the weight of a large spacecraft, astronauts, and the supplies needed in order to get to Mars. Fortunately, companies have already spotted the problems and are trying to fix it. Most likely, rockets will have to make several trips in order to drop off supplies to a lower Earth vehicle. There, astronauts will slowly build the vehicle over time and then rocket off to the red planet. And that still requires some heavy lifting. But in the future, this might get easier. Scientists on NASA are hoping to have the space launch system's first flight ready by 2019, which will be the biggest rocket ever flown, even bigger than Saturn V that carried the astronauts to the moon. The private company SpaceX is also working on that with the launch of the new Falcon Heavy flight, and which it would have less cargo than NASA's big rockets, but still much greater than anything around today. Now, another big problem is rocket fuel. Around 80% of the inertial mass launched into space is going to be rocket propellant. Trouble is, storing that amount in space is hard. Our objects in low Earth orbit travel around the world every 90 minutes, oxygen, which are rocket fuel, to vaporize. And unless the tanks are regularly vented, containers with those materials in it will likely explode. Hydrogen is very susceptible of leaking out of a tank, and it would result a loss of about 4% per month. Do the math. If a Mars mission was to take a year to assemble in low Earth orbit, then it would use more than half of its propellant before even departing to a red planet. At a cost of about $10,000 to send 1 kilogram to space, that would be an expensive waste. Now, the good part, the landing. Scientists are working on supersonic rocket propulsion, which is basically a gigantic balloon-like objects that would stiffen and expand in order to slow the landing vehicle down. But the key technology to landing people on the Martian surface is supersonic rocket propulsion. A spacecraft comes into the Martian atmosphere at a whopping 24,000 kilometers per hour. Even after slowing down with the help of a parachute or an inflatable, it would still be traveling well above the speed of sound. And simply sparking a rocket flame would be something like trying to light up a candle while someone is blowing on the wick the entire time. Once you have your thruster going, injecting that flame into an extremely dynamic environment would be something our technology has never had to face before. SpaceX is currently working on a reusable rocket tank that would descend from orbit and back onto their launch pads. They're planning to test supersonic rocket propulsion later this year, which could be used on both Earth and future Martian missions. With all of those ideas from the most brilliant minds of the 21st centuries, the problems we face seem comparable. If there's one thing which has defined human nature throughout history, it is our irrepressible impulse to move, to discover and cross new frontiers, to adapt to new environments, to appease that same unquenchable curiosity which has prompted our earlier ancestors to discover the Earth 2 million years ago. Our willingness to travel has allowed us to populate the planet. On July 20th of 1969, we achieved the impossible. Today, we need to bring back the same enthusiasm and ambition we had during the space race. When the first humans set foot on Mars, the moment will be more significant in terms of technology, exploration, and philosophy than any that have come before it. So, it is time to explore not only the solar system, but others. Exploration is in our nature, and spreading out might be the only thing that saves us from ourselves. Because somewhere, something incredible is waiting to be known. We begin as wanderers, and we are wanderers still. We have lingered